Sit back and relax. It's time for Sandy's Anecdotes.
Do you know, my grandfather had had two glass eyes and yet he could see. So what happened was he lost one eye, but he wasn't careless, he was ill. And and he had a glass eye made, which was perfect, exactly like his other perfectly working blue Scandinavian eye. And then he had one made that was bloodshot. And it was known as Grandpa's party eye. And he, and he kept it on in a box on the mantelpiece. And when he was going out for the evening, he'd take out the false blue one, and he'd put in the bloodshot one, and he'd say, "I'm going out now, and I shan't be back till they match."
Oh, that's brilliant! That's brilliant! Fantastic.
Speaking of the moon, do you know that the original video recording of the first moon landing on the 20th of July 1969 no longer exists? Did you know this? In 2006, NASA admitted they couldn't find the original videos, and it turned out the tapes had been erased and reused in the 80s to save money. Luckily enough, there were some good archive copies found. Does anybody know where I was the 20th of July 1969?
Denmark?
Are you being...
No.
Were you faking the footage?
I was 11 years old.
Were you there in America?
I was
on the moon.
I was in. I was in mission control in Houston.
Yeah. You were.
I was. My dad was a foreign correspondent, and that's why I was there. And I said to this woman, "Are you all right?" She said, "I'm kind of nervous. My boss is about to step out onto the moon." And I said, "Oh, don't worry. I'll hold your hand." So when Neil Armstrong stepped out of the moon, I was holding his secretary's hand.
Oh. Sandy, you're like Earth's real-life Princess Leia. Because you were watching it there.
Is that a good thing?
Yes, that's definitely
a
good thing.
Is that why you've had your hair done like her?
Yes.
For about a year, I worked as a journalist, and we used to drink in a pub that was half journalists and half crooks. Not easy to tell the difference, to be honest with you. And there was a bloke called Charlie, and Charlie was definitely a crook. And I said, "Oh, Charlie, how are you? I haven't seen you for a couple of weeks." He said, "No, I've been up the nick." And I said, "Oh, what was the charge?" He said, "Murder one." I said, "I said, all right, did you do it?" He said, "No, but I owed them one." And he said, "Honestly, while I was waiting for the charges to come through, my arsehole was going like that." I haven't seen him for ages. I don't know why we didn't stay friends.
I really hope he turns up on the next series of Baker.
Turn me life around.
I'm going to make you an entremet. Now.
Paul and Prue came over, my arsehole's going on. I thought these frogs and blackbirds won't stay in this pie.
Every time I feel slightly anxious, I always think of them.
Imagine knowing that there's a man out there and every time you feel anxious, you think of his arsehole.
I met Tom Jones once. I was producing a play which Tom Jones was going to be in, and I was due to meet him at the Dorchester Hotel. And when I arrived, they said, "Mr. Jones would like you to go up to his suite." So I thought, fair enough.
So she went up there.
I met her.
That was the press outside the window.
And I knocked on the door, and he opened the door, and he was wearing the shortest dressing gown I've ever seen in my life. Just
here. Have you seen Little Tom?
No. Anyway.
I level with Little Tom, I imagine. What?
He's actually charming. We got on very well. I was once lucky enough to meet Julie Andrews. It's the only time in my entire life I've been completely speechless.
Because she wouldn't shut up.
She just asking me what my favourite things were. It's very annoying.
I'm not laughing. I don't know.
Do you like him tied up with string? Yeah. I bet you do, girl. I bet you do. What's a deer? What's a female deer? Come on. Do you want to see the goat,
Herb? Holly on the hill!
It wasn't me singing. Holly on the hill! I'm Maria. I'll be back with you. I'm Maria. Shut up, Julie. Gods.
My son phoned me up from university and he said, "Can my red sweatshirt go in the washing machine?" Because he was new to doing laundry. And I said, "I don't know, darling. What does it say on it?" And he went away for about 5 minutes, came back, he said, "Manchester United."
In fact, I was once at Wembley Stadium and I went to wash my hands. And when I got to the sink, there were three penises urinating into the sink.
No! On their own? Now we already know how it works.
They couldn't be bothered to queue for the urinals. They just used the sink where I was trying to wash my hands. And they're here tonight.
Did you ever play the old comedy store?
Yes, I played the old comedy store. And I went, the first time I went in the dressing room, Arthur Smith and Paul Merton were in there. And they introduced themselves and into the toilets over there, and it was the sink.
Yeah, so it was, there was just a basin in the corner of the room, and they weren't much... really expecting girls.
I was just going to say, not much good for us.
No, well, Josie Lawrence used to lift me up. I once went to gay rodeo in the United States. It was fantastic, because instead of the thing where they have to throw a ball down, they try and put underpants on a goat. It's one of the funniest things... Stuffing phone boxes was the ice bucket challenge of its day. Did anybody do the ice bucket challenge?
No.
I had the weirdest experience with that. So I didn't know anything about it. And my son phoned me up and he said, Mum, Daniel Craig has just challenged you to the ice bucket challenge. Now, I never met Daniel
Craig.
Yeah. Anyway, as chance would have it, that evening I was at a party and there he was. So I went up to him and I said, you bastard. Why have you challenged me to this thing? I said, the chances of us ever meeting again, very slight. Let's do it straight away. So we were backstage at the Royal Festival Hall. We went into my dressing room and into the shower. And I have a video of me and Daniel Craig in the shower doing the ice bucket challenge.
Do you spend your whole time with showbiz men semi-naked?
Did he come out wearing a very short dressing gown?
Sandy, I thought I understood you, but I'm...
I'm like a magnet. He was perfectly charming. And I have to say, in terms of an ice bucket challenge, it was possibly not great because we didn't want to do a whole bucket of ice because, you know, we were at a party, so it was more of a gin and tonic, really.
So, we've gone from the ice bucket challenge to you had a gin and tonic with Daniel Craig.
Over my head.
Yeah. You know that Tom Jones story?
Yeah. Thank you for watching. Do remember to subscribe to the QI channel and click here to watch more videos. Please, come on, pick something.